everybody. Let's talk about fish and climate change.
Different fish species have different habitats and different preferred water temperatures. So they have different ranges. Some like it cooler, some like it warmer. As waters in the ocean and estuaries start to increase, that's going to affect where we find different fish species. For example, in the Hudson River, we used to have a fish called the rainbow smelt. Rainbow smelt generally like cooler waters. So, over time, as waters have gotten warmer, fewer and fewer smelt were found in the Hudson, and now we don't find any rainbow smelt at all. They've sort of moved north. Another species of fish we find, particularly in the lower Hudson and New York Harbor, is the Atlantic tomcod. Tomcod also like somewhat cooler waters. And right now, the Hudson is pretty much the southern end of their range. If the waters get much warmer in the Hudson and Harbor, we may see tomcod leave as well. So, as waters warm and species ranges move northward here in North America, even though we're losing some species like the smelt and possibly the tomcod, we also start to see warmer water species becoming more and more common. For example, our friends down at the Brooklyn Bridge Park Conservancy have lent us a couple of beautiful fish that actually give us hints as to what's going on in warmer climates. For example, look at this beautiful striped burr fish. This is a close cousin of the puffer fish. And just like the puffer fish, when they get really annoyed, they can actually puff themselves up. Unlike the puffer fish, they actually have small, short spines all over their body and this beautiful coloration. By the way, don't worry, we're gonna put this burrfish right back in its fish tank in just a second. Burrfish have been found along the east coast of North America, but their range is starting to creep northward. This is an example of a fish that we might see more and more of at Chesapeake Bay and the Mid-Atlantic coast, and even in New York Harbor, where this one was found by our Brooklyn friends. So, that's a striped burrfish. Sometimes when we go seining along New York Harbor or Long Island's coast, especially in the late summer or early fall, we may find some incredible tropical visitors. Fish species that are found more in the south, in the Caribbean, in the Bahamas, but they've been swept north on the Gulf Stream current and ended up in New York. Some of these are truly beautiful. Our friends at the Brooklyn Bridge Park Conservancy, they caught this amazing spot fin butterfly fish. Just look at those colors. This is such an incredible find. Now, the truth is, this warm water species probably couldn't survive New York's cold winters. But because researchers and educators and students are out there studying the fish of New York Harbor and the Hudson River, it's giving us a better picture on how currents and oceans and climate change may be affecting which species are where and how ranges of different species may be changing. Keeping an eye on nature is a really important part of studying and dealing with climate change. We thank you for all of the exploration you're doing in nature. Thanks. That is pretty fish.